Hey guys, I am Venkat and this is part 6 of Web Development with Blazor series. I'll include the link to this course playlist in the description below this video. At the moment, when we navigate to this root application URL, we see the list of employees. This list of employees are displayed by this index.razor component, and this component is present in the pages folder in blazorproject.client. And if we take a look at this index.razor component, notice the list of employees are hard-coded within the component itself. Now, what we want to be able to do is retrieve this employees data from SQL Server database. So, in this video, we'll discuss how to make HTTP calls to send and receive server-side data from a Blazor WebAssembly app. As we already know, a Blazor WebAssembly application runs on the client side in the browser. What if the application needs server-side data? Well, it can communicate with the server over HTTP. In Blazor, we use a class called HTTP client to make HTTP calls to send and receive data from an API. In both the hosting models, that is Blazor WebAssembly and Blazor Server, we use the same HTTP client class. There are several approaches to use this HTTP client class. A word of caution though, if not implemented correctly, it can lead to problems like socket exhaustion or failing to handle DNS changes. Going through all these different approaches is too time consuming and only makes it more confusing. So to keep it simple, let's use the recommended approach. For real-world enterprise apps, the recommended approach is to use iHTTP Client Factory. This approach works with both the hosting models, that is, Blazor WebAssembly and Blazor Server. It's the same code that we use in both the hosting models, which obviously means it's easy to convert a Blazor Server app to a Blazor WebAssembly app and vice versa. It also offers several benefits like providing a central location for configuring HTTP client instances. It also avoids the problems like failing to handle DNS changes and socket exhaustion. At the moment, when we navigate to our application root URL /API/employees, we see 4 employees here. And these employees are coming from SQL Server database. And this URL that we have here is our REST API URL. We built this REST API from scratch in our previous video in this series. Again, I'll include the link to this course playlist in the description box below this video. So at the moment, this REST API retrieves both employees and department data. Now, here's what we want to do. We want to be able to consume this REST API from our Blazor WebAssembly app. Now, if we want, a Blazor component can directly call a server-side REST API. However, for separation of concerns, let's implement a separate wrapper service that uses the HTTP client instance to call server-side REST API to send and receive data. If you're wondering why a separate wrapper service, well, as I said before, for separation of concerns, we do not want our Blazor component to be doing too many things. If a component needs server-side data, it injects this wrapper service and calls it. So our natural first step is to implement a wrapper service that calls server-side REST API using the built-in HTTP client class. Let's add a new folder to this project, blazorproject.client. Name it services. We'll place all our wrapper services in this folder. So let's add a new class file as well. Actually, we need a new interface. So let's select interface and let's name it iEmployeeService. Make this interface public. And if we take a look at iEmployee repository in our blazorproject.server, and iEmployee repository is present in this models folder. So let's open this. This repository supports all CRUD operations, that is create, read, update, and delete employees and search. Now, if you take a look at this wrapper service that we are implementing, it's just a wrapper, meaning we want this interface also to support all these operations. So let's copy all these methods and paste them within our interface right here. We have a lot of compilation errors, and all of them are because we are missing the namespace for both these types, employee and gender. If you recollect from our previous videos in this series, both these types are present in this project, Blazor project dot shade. So let's bring in the required namespace by pressing control period. Our next natural step is to provide implementation for this interface. So to the same services folder, let's add a new class file. Name our class employee service. Implement the interface iEmployeeService. Remember, this employee service is just a wrapper service. It's going to use the built-in HTTP client class to call our server-side REST API. So we're going to inject HTTP client class into this employee service class using dependency injection. For that, we need a constructor. And the class that we want to inject is HTTP client. And this class is present in system.net.http namespace. Let's bring that in. And let's also call the parameter HTTP client and generate the required private field by pressing control period and then select this second option. First, let's provide implementation for this getEmployees method. And if you look at the return type, this method is returning task of IEnumerable of employee objects, basically the list of all employees we have in our employees database table. Now we have already injected HTTP client instance. So on the injected instance, we have get from JSON async method. And this method is present in a different namespace. So let's bring in that namespace as well. Now, what is this get from JSON async method going to do? Well, it's going to call this REST API and retrieve the list of employees. And if you look at this REST API, it returns the list of employees in JSON format. So this method, as the name implies, get from JSON async, is going to take the list of employees in JSON format and automatically serialize them to IEnumerable of employee objects. So let's specify the same generic parameter here as well. And we also have to tell it the API endpoint. Our list of employees are available at /API/employees. As the name implies, this method getFromJSONAsync is an asynchronous method. So let's await its execution. And since we are using await keyword, we also have to turn this method into an async method. That's it, just this one line of code. We are done with the implementation of this getEmployees method. We'll provide the implementation for the rest of these methods in this employee service in our upcoming videos. In addition to this getFromJSONAsync helper method, we also have post as JSON async, put as JSON async. And for deletion, it's not delete as JSON async, it's simply delete async. We'll see these methods in action in our upcoming videos. Our second step is to install this NuGet package, microsoft.extensions.http. This package includes add HTTP client extension method. In a bit, we'll see how we are going to use this method, but first let's install this NuGet package. It's in this client project that we want to install this NuGet package. So right click on blazorproject.client and select this option, manage NuGet packages. Make sure you are in the browse tab, and the package that we want to install is microsoft.extensions.http. Select the package and then click install. Package installation complete. Next, we need to configure HTTP client factory and related services. We do that in a main method, and this main method is present in this file, program.cs. Notice, when I hover the mouse over services, it is of type iServiceCollection. So to this service collection, we need to add HTTP client services. For that, on builder.services, we have add HTTP client method. And this method is coming from the NuGet package that we just installed, microsoft.extensions.http. And then to this method, we specify our wrapper service interface and implementation. The interface is iEmployeeService. Let's bring in the required namespace. And the implementation is employeeService. Now, if we take a look at getEmployees implementation within our wrapper service, notice the path that we have specified here is only the endpoint /API/employees, but the full path to get to this endpoint is right here, localhost colon 44373/API/employees. So this part, localhost colon port number, this is called the base address. And we need to specify this as well. And we do that right here where we are configuring our HTTP client services. So we specify a parameter here. Let's call it client. Client dot base address equals, we can use this builder variable to get the base address. So builder dot hosting environment dot base address, and this is a URI. So let's use a new instance of the URI class. Notice when I have the mouse over this add HTTP client method from the IntelliSense, you can see it adds iHTTP client factory and related services to the service collection. Since we're using HTTP client factory to configure and manage HTTP client instances, we don't need this line right here. By the way, this line is added here by the Blazor WebAssembly app template that we have used to create this project. So let's keep this line commented. All that is left right now to do is inject this wrapper service, iEmployee service, into our index component and then retrieve data from the REST API. First, let's clean up this component a bit. First of all, we don't need this huge load data method within our component. So let me delete that first. We are also not going to use this onInitialized method. We're going to use its async counterpart. So let's delete this. And then notice when I type override and then press the spacebar, we can see all the methods that we can override. We want to override this onInitialized async method. We want to inject our wrapper service into this component. For that, we use the inject attribute. The service interface is iEmployee service. And let's name this service employee service. This service is present in this namespace, blazorproject.client.services. We can include this namespace in the component itself if we want to, but a better place is actually this imports.razor file. If we include the namespace in this file, then we can use the services in this namespace in any of our Blazor components. Notice now, in the index component, we don't have that red squiggly anymore. And on this injected employee service, we have getEmployees method, which returns the list of employees. And we're going to use that list to populate this employees property within our component. So employees equals whatever is the list our service returns, because this component binds to this employees property. And we know this getEmployees method is an async method. So let's await its execution. Since we are using await keyword, let's turn this method into an async method. And if you take a look at this employees property, it is of type list of employee, whereas this getEmployees method returns an iEnumerable of employee objects. So let's convert this iEnumerable of employee objects to a list of employee objects. And for that, we use the toList extension method. With all these changes in place, let's run our project. There we go. We see the list of 4 employees as expected. Now, let's quickly recap the steps. Step 1, implement wrapper service. This wrapper service uses the built-in HTTP client class to call the REST API to send and receive server-side data. Step 2, install the NuGet package microsoft.extensions.http. This is the package that contains add HTTP client extension method. Step 3, we use the add HTTP client extension method to add HTTP client factory and related services to the dependency injection container. We do this configuration in a main method in program.cs file. Finally, step 4, inject wrapper service in any of your Blazor components and use it to send and receive server data. To inject a service into a Blazor component, we use the inject attribute. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.